Hello friends, this is my review of the Exceed Mini MadBeast 1/18 scale monster truck. Let's start out with a quick overview. This truck is a brushed version featuring a brushed 370 motor with a combo speed control and receiver and a 2.4 GHz generic radio. It has four-wheel drive. Some other features include a LiPo battery, full ball bearings, and front and rear bumpers from the factory. Now that you know a bit about it, let me share some thoughts with you. This truck is only $69.95 US plus taxes and shipping. The shipping will vary depending on where in the world you are located. That's less than the price of the higher end toy grade RCs in retail stores. So let's talk about the durability. Although no model is bulletproof, I jumped, crashed, and flipped this truck in many different scenarios. The only two problems I ran into was that one of the front knuckles broke when the wheel hit a curb at full speed on pavement. This probably would have happened to any hobby grade model. Another one of the problems was one of the spur gears started to wear down after around 10 runs. This could have simply been related to improper alignment between the spur and pinion from the factory. I decided to run the truck without any checks beforehand, as this should be a novice or beginner hobbyist truck from the description. To me, this means it should be able to run right out of the box, and this was mainly the case except possibly with the gear mesh. Pretty minor stuff, so I won't spend a lot of time on it. Let's talk about the perks. I really liked having ball bearings out of the box. This is a nice upgrade for such a low-cost RC. Also, many lower-end, name-brand RCs are still including old megahertz-based radio systems with giant antennas with their models. Exceed gives you a 2.4 GHz system right out of the box, which is great. I also love the inclusion of a LiPo battery. It makes such a huge difference to runtimes and power, and again, most name brands still include nickel metal hydride batteries with their RTR kits. Four-wheel drive is another great perk. Most entry-level models are rear-wheel drive only. I also like the included charger. It's basic, but it charges at 1.2 amps, which is awesome because many of the other basic chargers I've seen only charge around half an amp. This means much lower charging times and more play time. Let's talk about the adaptability. I was able to run this truck in dirt, gravel, cement, and grass without much of a problem. I have to add, it did bog down a little bit in the longer grass. For example, a base oil field that hasn't been cut in a couple weeks. That could potentially burn the motor out. On that note, my motor never did burn out. Let's talk about the speed. I'm not sure if you can really tell in the videos, but I'd say this truck was hitting around 30 to 40 kilometers an hour. That's about as fast as you'd want to go with an all-plastic chassis, and it's fast enough that any beginner hobbyist would be impressed. Now let's talk about some things I did not like about this truck. Let's talk about the turning radius. You can see this many times in the video. The turning radius on this truck is terrible. I'm not sure if it's the factory setup, but you need a lot of air to turn this truck around unless you can spin the wheels a little bit. Since I left it set up as it was out of the box, this is probably a problem many will have. On more than one occasion I had a runaway truck. This didn't happen on every outing, but at least 2 out of the 10 runs the truck would stick at about 75% throttle until I shut it off and back on again. At that point the truck would stop reacting completely until I shut it and the radio off and on a few times. Even then would sometimes no longer steer properly or only go forward. As is the norm with the RTRs, the tires on this truck don't offer much in the way of grip. It was pretty squirrely on everything but clean pavement. You can drive on dirt and gravel, but expect to do a lot of correction and sliding around. Not a deal breaker for me, as the tires were simply an attempt to get the truck at least drivable in most situations, and it is. The main gripe I have is about the shipping fees associated with parts replacement for the truck. I think it's more reasonable in the US, but if you live anywhere outside of the lower 48, forget about it. I was quoted $29 for a $1 part, which is unacceptable. I'm used to having to pay a little bit more for shipping being based in Canada, but this is excessive. On that note, I should certainly mention that I took these concerns to the forums at Nitro RCX, and they ended up telling me this was a bug and shipped me the part free of charge. They said that their web team was also looking into it and fixing it. I just wanted to give a heads up. I recently checked back a couple weeks after I made the initial complaint to order a new spur gear, and the same issue was occurring. Just another note on the body, this is a minor detail, but the material this body is made out of is the type of material I know doesn't stand up to cold temperatures well. I've had similar bodies shatter like glass in cold weather. This truck isn't waterproof out of the box, I do not believe, but in case you decide to take that route, beware. Overall, this truck was a ton of fun. It held well in almost every situation, and if Nitro RCS can get their shipping costs under control, I think it's a worthwhile investment. It's a great take-along truck if you want to go camping or on vacation and take something with you. You can be pretty certain it will hold together and it's nice and small. I can't really compare this truck to much else because it's in such a low price range, but it's almost certainly in its own category. The only truck I can think that might be comparable is the WL Toys A979, which I'll be doing a review on shortly. So I have to say at this point in time that it's probably the best you can get for children you want to introduce to the hobby, or people who are just starting out and aren't sure they want to invest the money. Most other 18 scale models I've seen start between around $110 and $150 at the hobby store. So here are my rankings. Durability, 8 out of 10. So only minor issues potentially related to the factory setup. The fun factor, 7 out of 10. Lots of fun, but not perfect. Problems with traction, steering, and glitchy radio take some points away. Parts support, 5 out of 10. The parts are there and the prices are good, but shipping fees are way too high. Price, 8 out of 10. The initial investment is low, but all those shipping fees may catch up if things break often. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed my review of the 1/18th scale Mini MadBeast from Exceed RC. If you liked the video, please click like below, or subscribe to my channel for more interesting RC videos and reviews. Until next time, friends.